Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome back to Repair and Replace. A dirty furnace circulates dust around your home, is less efficient, and more expensive to run. Your furnace should be cleaned and inspected before it's first turned on. This gives a chance to identify any problems beforehand, so you won't have any surprises when winter arrives. In today's episode, I'll show you a few simple ways to keep your furnace running smoothly. To begin, you'll need gloves, a vacuum, a brush, a furnace filter, and a screwdriver or nut driver. When working on your furnace, always shut off the power and close the gas valve. A furnace filter removes dust, pollen, and other particles from the air. Over time, a buildup of dust on the filter will restrict the airflow, reducing the efficiency of the furnace. If the airflow is reduced too much, the heat exchanger can actually overheat. This is why it's essential to replace the furnace filter every 3 to 6 months. The filter is located on the cold air return duct. Pull the filter out and look at the direction of the arrows on the filter. Use a Sharpie and draw an arrow over top so you will always know which way to install the filter. In most furnaces, the disposable filter will have a cardboard frame and should be replaced. In some models, it can be vacuumed or washed, but first check your furnace manual. If you don't see any numbers on your filter, then stand the filter upright and measure the height, width, and thickness. After you've selected the filter type and size, then select the MERV rating, or Minimum Efficiency Reporting Value. The MERV rating will tell you how good a filter is at cleaning the air. As long as you match the right size filter and the MERV rating, generic filters will perform identical to OEM filters. Remove the top cover panel. Many furnaces use a push lock or twist lock, but some furnaces will require a screwdriver or a socket wrench. Now, use a shop vac to clean the inside. A clean toothbrush can be used for any hard-to-reach places. If you have access to the heat exchanger, then look for any cracks or deformities. If you see any cracks, then call a professional. The heat exchanger could be releasing carbon monoxide into your home. Now, look at the burner assembly. In some models, this is hidden behind a cover. Now, if you see any scorch marks or burnt wires, then call a professional, as this is a strong sign that the flames are rolling out the front of the burner. The blower fan pushes air over the heat exchanger and circulates it around your home. And dust can collect on the fan blades, so it's best to clean them too. First, remove the blower cover panel. When accessing the blower assembly, it's best to wear cut-resistant gloves. Sheet metal can have sharp edges, so be careful. Next, unscrew the mounting screws. You might have to remove the control board if it's mounted in front of the blower. First, take a picture so you'll know how to reconnect the wires afterwards. Now, disconnect the motor wires. Unscrew and set the control board off to the side. Now, slide the blower assembly out. Use a brush to clean the blower wheel and vacuum the assembly. Align the rails and slide the blower assembly into place. Next, secure the control board and reconnect the wires. Now, tighten the mounting screws. Many furnaces have a switch that cuts power to the furnace if the blower cover is open, so make sure that the panel is properly aligned and secure. Now, replace the upper cover. Next, open the gas valve. Now, turn on the power to your furnace. The furnace should be running normally. If this is the first time running the furnace this year, you might smell a little bit of dust. Usually, this doesn't last long, but call a professional if the smell doesn't go away. Now, if your furnace is having trouble running, then watch our troubleshooting guide for a step-by-step breakdown. And there's a link to this in the description below. If you found this video useful, then subscribe to our channel. We're constantly filming new content every week, so let us know what repairs you'd like to see next. And if you need a part for that repair, then visit our website. We stock thousands of hard-to-find parts, and we'll ship it out to you the same day. Thanks for watching.